Welcome to 14th lecture of Analog Integrated Circuits Design. We covered single stage amplifiers. In previous class, we also saw the concept of cascoding, adding one transistor to the top of the other input transistor. We derived the expression for output impedance as well as voltage gain. Today, we'll continue a little more discussion on cascode, and then we'll try to get familiarized with another concept called as folded cascode. Let me start with cascode. So last week we have seen an input device and a device added to the top of that. On the similar way, on the load side also we had, you remember this was the structure we have looked at. All right. So input device, a cascode to input device, then load and a cascode to the load. And this structure is often called as double cascode. Or when you have transistors like this, we call this as even telescopic also, but this make more sense when we discuss about op-amp. So just hold on this, but this is called as double cascode because you have a second device to the top of the input device. In a similar line, but we also saw that one observation what we made is as you stack one device or as you stack devices on a same transistor to the top of the same transistor, more gain is available, but that is actually by compromised or that is achievable only at a reduced voltage swing. All right. So in the same line, if one tried to add more transistors, so now I added one transistor. What is the problem if I add one more transistor to the top of the input transistor? So that is also possible. So let me say this is the input device. With M1, this is Vin. Now we know how to add one transistor. So I'm just adding one transistor to the top. I'm calling it as M2, suitably biased with VB, say VB1. Now, it is also possible to stack it further by adding one more device. Let me call it as VB2 in this fashion. And this is M3 device. So whenever we have such a connection by adding one more device or when there are three transistors in stack, we call this configuration as triple cascode. When you have three transistors in stack, we call this as a triple cascode configuration. All right. Now, if you want to convert this to an amplifier circuit, what you should do is you should keep suitable loads. So that means you have to add suitable loads here. So one is for the cascode device M3, I should have corresponding device here. Let me call this as VB3. Now for M2 device, you should have a corresponding cascode load. So this is, I'll number it. So this is VB4. And finally, for the input device, you should have another cascode with VB5 as the voltage, right? So this can be suitably numbered as maybe any number you can use, M4. I'll just mark it as M4, M5 and M6. Right. So why I have used different color is just to identify that. So this can be seen as, this is your very basic structure. When you say you have a CS amplifier with this as Vin and this as Vout and this as VB. This is M1 device and this is M2 device. This is your basic CS amplifier. But when you keep stacking devices to the top of this, you can actually go and add devices one on the top of the other, and you can result in even something called a triple cascode. All right, so the color specifically indicates that this one, M1 is input device, M2 is the first cascode and M3 is the second cascode. Similarly on the load side. Now, if I'm asking you to if I'm asking you to find the gain expression, how will you write the gain expression for this? I think you will be writing AV as the transconductance of the structure, say minus GM into the output impedance seen here. So I can say that the impedance seen here is the impedance seen up. I may call it as R up in parallel to the impedance seen down, which is R down. So this is what we can write in general, R up in parallel to R down. Right. Now, GM in this case also I'll simplify and I say this is approximately equal to small GM1. You can analyze that by neglecting in the channel length modulation, but this is approximate value. You can definitely find an estimate, but GM1 equal to small GM1 holds good as long as your input device is having grounded source terminal grounded. Now what about R up and R down? So what will be the value of R up and R down? Can Anvay, are you there? Anvay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Anvay, can you help me in finding what is R down?
R down, GM1, R0 to R0 1.
Okay. You are confused. You have confusion? All right, okay. I'll help. Yeah, okay, no problem. I'll check with Nisha. Nisha, are you there? All right, okay. Nisha is not there. Fine. So what we will do here is I'll help you. So we know that looking from this, from at the drain of the transistor, the resistance is R0 1. The same thing if I see from the drain of another transistor, this R0 1 will be magnified by the intrinsic gain of this, which is GM2 into R0 2. Right. Now, the same resistance is again seen from the drain of another transistor. So this value, which is GM2 R0 2 R0 1, will be now magnified by GM3 into R0 3 approximately. Right. That is R down. Similarly, I can write that R up is equal to it is R0 6 first magnified by GM5 R0 5, that is further magnified by GM4 R0 4. So if you write the this is R up and R down, so if you write the voltage gain here, I can write it as minus GM1 into GM3 R0 3 GM2 R0 2 into R0 1 in parallel to GM4 R0 4 GM5 R0 5 into R0 6. This is the voltage gain expression. So after writing such a huge voltage gain, you should also understand that when you have such a large voltage gain by stacking the many number of devices like this, the voltage swing is reduced considerably. Voltage swing is reduced considerably, and we can say that the voltage swing will be as low as if you calculate the value, it will be VDD minus. You have there are 6 transistors in stack, so approximately I can say it is VDD minus 6 overdrive voltages, which is actually a huge reduction from the voltage headroom, right? So the whole idea of having a triple cascode or a cascode is not just just to use it as an amplifier. One another application or one another way what I can use this cascode is, cascode is widely used in biasing circuits. So now you will be wondering why or how cascode can be used in biasing circuit. The answer is, we know that for biasing we need current sources. So by cascoding, we saw that it is cascoding structures are giving larger voltage, a larger output resistance. So if I can use a cascode source, definitely I can get a better current source, for the reason that an ideal current source is having an infinite output impedance with a constant current value. Now, if I can use a cascode, definitely by improving the output impedance, I can definitely go for a better current source or the in biasing circuit. So we will not be seeing, we will not see cascode. Yeah, we'll just see cascode current source because you have the basics of current mirror from your previous course AMC. So we'll try to build upon that and see how cascoding can be helpful in biasing. All right. So any questions in this? If you have any questions, please let me know. Or you can please put a message in the chat box. All right. So let me explain a little bit on how cascoding can be helpful in having a better current source. For that, let me take a single transistor case first. Say your lambda is not equal to zero. So say this is the Wien device. Now, say this node, at this node, at the drain of this input device. Okay, Amitesh, I saw your question. Biasing. Okay, yeah, your question is to bias what, right? Yes, so especially in integrated circuit, so you know that you remember or you understand what you mean by biasing. For you, when you learn the course analog microelectronic circuits, you have seen that the active devices like transistors should be properly biased to set the operating point and to keep in a particular region. For example, in order to bias a MOSFET, in order to keep a MOSFET in saturation region, you have used a resistive voltage divider bias and thereby established the ID and a VGS value and kept that MOSFET in saturation region. So in the previous course, we were depending on something called as resistive or a voltage divider bias. But now in integrated circuits, we will not use that resistors in that way because of the bulky size and the power dissipation. What we do is we need an alternate way to bias the circuit. So that is usually done with the help of current sources, right? So with respect to that, this cascoding will help in developing a biasing circuit, right? So I'll give you a little more clarity, Amitesh, by considering a biasing network. So far, we did not consider any biasing network. We were directly assuming that the transistors were in saturation. Now, as I was telling, when we start simulating circuits in LTSpice, we have to take care of all these things. All right. So what I want to say here is, say there is a small change in a voltage here. Say if there is a delta V change in the voltage at the drain of this transistor, what do you think? How the current here, how the delta I current? So will there be a change in current through the device? If there is a change, how much will be that change? That is my question. The question is, there is a transistor and the drain terminal is having the drain terminal voltage is changed by a small amount called delta V. If that is the case, how much will be the change in current? Whether there will be a change in current, if there is a change in current, how much will be the change in current? Can I get some response in the chat box? My first question is, will there be any change in current? The answer will be simple, right? Either it will be yes or no. No, yes, there will be a change in current. Yeah, because the drain voltage also is having dependency on the drain current. Even small signal drain voltage will change drain current, and that will be delta I. All right. Now, what will be this change in delta I, change in current here? That will be equal to the change in voltage divided by the small signal resistance seen from here. Since it is drained, the small signal resistance will be delta V by R naught. All right. Now, the same thing, I am just again looking at this change for a cascode structure. So this is V in. Consider both lambda not equal to zero. This is suitably biased as VB. Now look at this point and say there is a small change in voltage delta V. So similarly, I can expect a change in current I, but what will be the change in current now, delta I? Delta I will be equal to the change in voltage divided by resistance seen from here. Now the resistance seen from here is equal to, if I consider one as M1 and another as M2, say if I call this as M1 and this as M2, I can write the resistance as GM2 R02 into R01. Right. So by looking at these two cases, I can clearly say that whenever you have a Cascode device, Cascode device is basically shielding. So this device is shielding, shielding this node. Previously, this node was exposed, and whenever there is a change, the change in current is delta V by R0. Now, when you keep a Cascode device is basically shielding the transistor node from such a large or a huge change in current. Why am I saying so? Because you see that now that the denominator term is actually huge, and because of this large denominator, delta I is considerably reduced. So what is the meaning of this? Whenever you have a Cascode structure, the change in current is basically less. So I will make a note here that Cascode transistors shield the input transistors, or I'll say input devices, from voltage variation at the output. Right. That means because of the larger output impedance, the current change was minimized in the case of a Cascode structure. So this also will give you some glimpse that when you use Cascode structures, you will have a better current source. All right, that is a takeaway from here. Now, one more thing we'll quickly see. If you have questions, please post, or please hold on. I'll take questions after some time. Now, so cascoding, basically what is happening in cascoding is we are trying to increase the output impedance. There is one more way actually to increase the output impedance, that is just by increasing the length of the device. Let us see how it is. So now the question is, increasing length of a transistor or cascoding, which is better? Or like what is the difference when you have a transistor with a larger length and when you have a cascoding structure? So I'm considering this as one case where you have a transistor whose value is W by L, and this is V in, and the current carried by this is ID. Now I consider two other cases. One is with a single transistor with V in, but length of this device is 4 times larger than the previous one. That is one case. But in that example, I'm assuming that somehow drain current is kept constant. I'm not worrying about that, how it is. Now in third case, I look for a cascoding structure. So this is VB, this is VIN. Now let me number this as M1 and M2 because we have two transistors there. All right. So here also current is kept as M, but here the device size is mentioned as W by L. Now the question what I'm posing here is, can you comment on the overdrive voltage of all the three configurations, output impedance of all the three configuration, and voltage gain of all the three configuration? So when I ask this question, you can assume that there is a suitable load connected, and that load can be considered as an ideal current source. So keeping ideal current source in your mind, you can just think about all these three things. Right. So for those who are wondering what I'm doing now, what I'm trying to analyze here is, what is the difference when you have a cascode structure and when you have a transistor with an increased length? So why we are looking for this is, whenever you change your length, there will be a change in the resistance. How can I say that? We know that R0 is equal to 1 by lambda ID, and lambda is something which is directly proportional to L, the channel length modulation factor. So when there is a change in length, then there will be a change in lambda. All right. So when you have sorry, lambda is inversely proportional to L. So when you increase length, what will happen is you will, your lambda will actually reduce. When your lambda reduces, your R naught will increase. This is what the observation was. This is what we have seen so far. Lambda is a channel length modulation factor. When you have larger length, your lambda will reduce. That will in turn increase your output impedance. So now we will see which is better, whether to have a cascode device or to have a transistor with a larger length. So can I get the answers quickly? What will be the overdrive voltage in the first case? Let me mark these three as, so this is figure A, this is figure B, and this is figure C. So first I'll write what is VOV of A. You may be confused now. VOV of A is assuming is this is loaded using an ideal current source, and same in all the three cases. In that case, I can say that the overdrive voltage requirement of the single device here is only 1 VOV, right? What about second device VOVB? What is the overdrive voltage requirement? So now you have two devices, one with W by L value, another with W by 4L. Will there be any difference in the overdrive voltage? Can I get some response? All right. So Avinash, I think we have discussed that. Oh, we didn't discuss that. Yeah, because I think that is discussed in channel length modulation phenomena. All right. So that comes. Yeah. So the channel length modulation factor lambda. Yeah, I'll tell you at the end of the end of the class. So that is something what we learned in AMC. Because lambda is inversely related to L, I'll show that at the end of the class. As of now, please take this lambda is inversely proportional to L, Avinash. I'll give clarity on that. Yeah. So my question is, what will be the overdrive requirement of the second device or the B? Can you guys comment? So if I write overdrive voltage, which is VGS minus VT, I can write it as, by rearranging the drain current equation, it is 2ID by mu and C aux W by L, right? Now, if length is quadrupled, if your length is increased four times, what will be the overdrive voltage? Overdrive voltage will be increased by at least two times. So I can say this is equal to twice the VOV of the first stage. All right. Now, what about third? You have two transistors. So there is a minimum overdrive requirement for M1 transistor, which is VGS minus VT. Similarly, there is a minimum overdrive requirement for M2 device, that is another VGS minus VT. So the total overdrive requirements for this VOVC can be written as 2 times overdrive voltage itself, 2 times VGS minus VT. Is this clear? Are you guys with me? Can I get some response? Are you guys with me? All right. Is this clear what we are doing? Okay, please ask questions in the chat box if you have any. Don't think that the question what you have is silly or something. Nobody will judge you here. All right. Now coming to R out, if I write the output impedance of the first stage, looking at the drain, it is directly R naught 1. In the second case, R out B can be written as, how will I write? Here what you can see is your length is increased four times. So when your length is increased four times, your lambda will reduce four times. If your lambda is reducing four times, because the lambda becomes lambda by four, that means that R naught will improve four times, or it will be four times the R naught of the previous stage. All right, that is R out B. And now, R out of C will be equal to, this is directly cascading, so it is GM2 R02 into R01. That is the output impedance of this. Similarly, if I write for the voltage gain, AVA can be written as minus GM1 into R01. Now this AVB can be written as minus GM1. Okay, so when your length is quadrupled, your GM also will, GM will go as half, right? If you are wondering, I can say GM1 is equal to under root of 2ID mu n C ox W by L. If your L is reduced 4 times, your GM will be reduced to half. Into 4 times of R naught, which is equal to 2 times of GM R naught. What about AB of the third case? It will be equal to GM1, GM2, R naught 2, R naught 1, or it is GM R naught the whole square. All right, so this is how we analyzed that. Analyze and compare three things. One is a single transistor, another one a transistor with increased length, and the third one is with a with a cascode structure. All right, so any questions in this? Now, if you want to have a comparison, what you can see is, so you can clearly say that the overdrive voltage or the overdrive voltage consumption in both the cases, when you have an increased length or when you have a cascoding, both are same, but you are getting an advantage of having a larger output impedance when you have a cascoding structure. All right. So overdrive voltage is doubled, and the transistor will definitely consume the same voltage headroom as same in both in cascode and this quadruple stage. So in that way, both will have, so the circuit, the configuration in B and C, both will have similar voltage swing constraints, but definitely there is a change in the cascode structure will have a higher output impedance, right? So that I am commenting here. Voltage headroom constraints are same. Same, but cascode have higher output impedance, higher R out. All right, so as I mentioned before, it is not mandatory that we have to use this as an amplifier itself. Very commonly used structure is to use this for cascode current sources to yield higher output impedance. Thereby, we will get almost the, not almost same, but we will get a response similar to that of an ideal current source. All right, so any questions so far? All right, so in that case, we'll quickly move and see what is this folded cascode structure. Folded cascode, the concept of folding. So now, if I again look back to the basic structure of cascoding, when you provide V in here with VB voltage here, this V out, VDD and RD, this is M1 and M2. If I look at the structure, what is basically happening is, whenever there is a small change in input voltage V in, that will be converted into a current here, ID, which is equal to GM1 into Vin, right? So this input device is converting this input voltage into a current. That is what you can see. Now, when you look at this device, the M2 device, which is the cascode structure, what is this cascode structure doing? This cascode structure is basically converting this current, or cascode structure is basically taking this current as the input, and it is acting upon that, right? So you have an input device and you have a cascode device, and we have same type of, if you look at both input and cascode, we have both devices are of same type. Both are of same type. Now, it is not mandatory that you should have input device and cascode device of the same type. When I say same type, it is not mandatory that you should use both NMOS, NMOS or PMOS, PMOS. It is not mandatory. Okay, so before telling that, let me draw even an amplifier with a PMOS cascode. So this is input voltage. This is the cascode structure, and this is the load connected RD, and this is Vout. This is the structure of a cascode amplifier with a PMOS input. Cascode amplifier with PMOS input. Now, what I said here is, it is not mandatory to use both input device and cascode device of the same type. We can actually use both with the different types. Now, when I do different types, two things we should consider or we should take care. One is, we should see that the devices are properly biased. And second point is, we should also see that the devices are connected suitably. So one thing what you can see here is, in both the structure, whether it is NMOS input type cascode, I'll again write this as cascode amplifier because heading is polar cascode, and you should not confuse that. Again, I'm calling the same cascode amplifier as folded cascode. That is not cascode amplifier with the NMOS input. So one clear thing from both these two structures are, the bias current of M1 is same as the bias current of M2. In this case also, bias current of M1 and M2 are same. So in a cascode structure, bias currents are, I can say it is reused. Why am I making that statement? Bias currents are reused because both M1 and M2 have same bias current. Both have same bias current. Do you have any questions? Okay, so when I say both have same bias current, the natural thing is, we will think that, is there a possibility to have different bias current? That is our new structure, what we call it as folded cascode. I'll tell you. So how to have a folded cascode structure is, so this, I'm just drawing the initial. This is VB. Are you guys with me? Are you guys following what I'm doing? All right. So this is the same structure. Just I have drawn by towards the other side. I have just rotated and kept the transistors. This is your initial structure or the regular NMOS cascode amplifier. Now, as I mentioned, both the devices can be of the different type. That means I will actually change this input device here. This input device, I am changing from there, and I am drawing towards, the signal is taken from here, and I am keeping a device which is PMOS because I'm connecting this directly to VDD. So this is my M1, this is M2, sorry, this is M2 and this is M1 from the previous circuit. Now this is my new M1. If I am confusing, please do let me know. This is Vin. So what I'm telling is, the bottom device M1 is folded and connected to the supply voltage, thereby made a structure, something called as folded cascode. So this is actually a folded cascode structure. So to make it clear, now this device is not there. So how will I draw the complete structure? So the resistance is there, then the cascode device is there. Now the input device is not NMOS, and since it is made as PMOS, I have made the connection in this form close to VDD, and this is the input. But one more thing you will observe now. In the previous circuit, there was only one stage, or there was only one vertical. All the transistors were connected to VDD and both were carrying equal current. But now what is the difference? There are two branches now. This is VDD and there are two branches. This is one branch, this is another branch with RD. This is output. So since there are two branches, this should be suitably biased, and I need to add a current source here. I'm calling it as I1, and what I will say here is the current flowing through ID plus ID2 is equal to I1. I'll just put this as magnitude value, because the current of M1 is a PMOS device. All right. Is this clear what I'm explaining now? So by having a structure of this type, I can change the input device to PMOS, and you have to add an additional current source here. So now if I look at the structure, why this is called as polar cascode, as I mentioned here, whenever there is a small change in Vin, the current flowing is GM and Vin, and the same current is taken by the M2 device. But what is happening here now, for GM Vin you will have a current here, it has GM Vin, but that is basically folded up in this fashion. This is the current direction, right? GM1 Vin is the direction of the current is this form, the signal current. That is why we call this as folded cascode. All right. Yeah, there is a question, why PMOS, why not only NMOS? Yeah, so this is another this is the popular way of having a structure. This is cascoding. So this is another possibility. If you want to change the device type, this is the suitable modification what you should make. And the answer for that why question, one more thing is, this has resulted in some good amplifier structures. This has resulted in some good amplifier structures. Again, I'm not telling that cascode is better than this. Both have its own merits and demerits. Okay, now your question is why the M1 device kept here is not an NMOS. Is that your question, Akash? Oh, all right. So you cannot. So the basic idea here is when you have a structure, you should maintain the same output impedance. You should maintain the same output impedance or relatively closer output impedance and almost same gain. All right. Now, if I replace this M1 with a NMOS device there, your structure. Okay, let us analyze the structure further, and then we will come back and say why NMOS cannot be kept in place of M1. Okay, let us do an analysis on this and we'll come back and see. All right. So this I started with NMOS cascode structure. And I got a folded cascode structure with PMOS input. All right, Akash, I'll definitely come back to your question. You will understand that better when we when I make that comment after discussing about the analysis. So this is the first. So one more thing I can do, if I have a PMOS structure, NMOS structure. Now, if I have a PMOS structure here, PMOS regular cascode, when you have this structure here, what will I do, or what should I do basically here? I should This is my input device PMOS. That should be folded down, right? So what I will do is I'll change this device type from PMOS to NMOS, and I keep it something like this. This is what I should do. So when I redraw the structure, this is Vin with M1. This is the same previous. So this is RD, this is Vout, and this is VB. Now, since there are two branches, this should be properly or suitably biased using a current source connected to the top I1 with the same relation. I1 will be equal to the sum of the current flowing through M1 and M2. Whether the structures are clear? So here I will write this as PMOS cascode amplifier and this as folded cascode with NMOS input. Folded cascode amplifier with the NMOS as the input. All right, so this is how we should understand, visualize the structure. Now, we have to understand the DC response also, but before that, I will ask you guys to find the output impedance of the structure, or let me give you a structure. So, so how this has to be is, when I say this has to be suitably biased, I just kept a current source there, but that should be replaced using a appropriate transistor, right? So let me give you one question on that. I'm just drawing a PMOS folded cascode. This has VDD. This is Vin. Or I'll just leave this as open. Now this is VB, this is M2, this is M1. And there should be a current source here at the bottom, as I mentioned, but I'll replace that current source with a transistor just for the analysis purpose here. And let me call this as say M3, and this is suitably biased. Now the question what I'm asking is, can you find what is the impedance? So this is the output point, right? So I want to find what is the output impedance in this case. Can you guys find the output impedance assuming lambda not equal to zero? So can I get answers from you guys? Can I get some answers for this? What is the output impedance? I think we had a similar question even for the assignment. GM2 R02 into R01 parallel. Very good, very good, Avinash. That is right. So, how will you analyze this question? If you look at the structure, you are asked to find the impedance from here, right? So if I, so for a single transistor, looking at here, it is R1, but now the source is not grounded. At source, there are some resistance. What is the resistance of this? There is R03 here, Now, again, looking at drain, you can see the resistance as R01. So at the source of M2, you have R01 and R03 in parallel. So R01 is in parallel to R03. Now that will be magnified as GM2 into R02. That is the output impedance of this structure. All right. Now, if you compare this with the cascode output impedance, definitely this output impedance is smaller. How it is smaller? In the cascode case, you have GM2 R02 into R01, but now that is reduced to R01 parallel to R03. So I can clearly say that this circuit will have an output impedance which is lower than the regular cascode. Regular cascode is your normal cascode amplifier, otherwise we call it as non-folded cascode. This is folded cascode and the other one is a non-folded cascode, right? Definitely the output impedance is smaller. Now I will, so you will be wondering what is the advantage. We'll come back to the advantage. Before that, now I want to answer the question what Akash asked me. I think Amitesh is asking how are the resistance in parallel. All right, Amitesh, can you unmute? Just want to give you more clarity on that. Hello, Amitesh, are you there?
Hello. Sir, am I audible now?
Yes, Amitesh, you're audible. Yeah, so you are asking how this R01 and R03 are in parallel, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me why they are not in parallel.
Sir, because one is connected to ground and the voltage connected are different now, sir. That's why.
Where it is connected different, you are looking at these points, right? Here, these two nodes are connected together.
R0, yes, sir, but one is connected to VDD and one more is connected to ground.
Okay, now what resistance we are looking here, which is the small signal resistance, right?
Yes, sir, understood.
Yeah, you understood?
Yes, sir, VDD, we consider it as zero and then it will be...
Very good, yes, very good.
Thank you, sir.
So since it is small signal resistance, VDD is ground and both are in parallel. Yeah. It is good that you asked, Amitesh, because maybe others also will have the same doubt. No issues. Okay, now coming back to the question of Akash. Akash, can you now tell me, when I do this change or when I change this device with as PMOS, can I keep NMOS there? If I am keeping NMOS there, what is the drawback? I have folded the structure and I replaced it with a PMOS. Now, if I am keeping that as NMOS, what will be the effect in the output impedance? If I am keeping it as an NMOS, you will have something like this, and this node will be connected here, right? What is the impedance seen here? It is 1 by GM. So this will be equal to R01 parallel to 1 by GM, which will reduce the impedance so much so that we no need to go even for this kind of biasing, because output impedance received will be very, very small. That is one thing. Second thing is, so whenever you, the second thing is you cannot directly connect a transistor in this fashion to a circuit, because you will be connecting this point to VDD. Now, what I want is, this is your input device, right? The input device and the transistor should be in saturation region. But you see, I am connecting this node to another point. That means your VGS, the VGS voltage will depend on even the biasing condition of the rest of the circuit. If you remember initially when we discussed about four structures, we told that two structures can act as a current source, another two structures cannot act as current source. The same reason holds good even in this case also. I hope, Akash, it was clear. If not, please do ask. I will give more clarity. All right. So this is a glimpse about folded cascode. We have to understand and analyze this in a little more better way that we will continue in next day's class. All right, Akash, your question back is biasing will be affected. It is not biasing. I'm not telling that biasing will be affected in this case. The transistor cannot be kept as NMOS for the obvious reason that the transistor should be in saturation when you provide an input voltage. And in saturation, what we are expecting out of a transistor is it should behave properly as a current source. That is not possible when you keep a transistor there in that fashion. That is what I meant. All right, so I can give more clarity on that if you have questions. So I'll be just winding up for today's class. So we just started with the regular cascode amplifier. We discussed about triple cascode first, and then we saw the shielding property. So this is called as shielding property of cascode devices. Then we saw the difference of using a transistor with an increased length and cascoding. And further, we saw the concept of folded cascode by drawing the regular cascode first and folding the input device. So the two structures, you should understand two structures. The only difference is we will have an additional transistor or a current source for biasing need. So we made one observation that the circuit will have a lower output impedance. One more observation is circuit will have or will need larger bias current than previous. Why? Because we have two branches. So for proper biasing, we are adding one more additional current. So the current is also larger. But still, this is a good thing with respect to one aspect that we will discuss. All right. So with this, I am winding up for today. If you have questions, you can ask. 1 second. Yes. So thank you so much for joining.